Hey, where are you going? The show hasn't even started yet.
I don't have anything to do, so I'm leaving.
Seriously? You should stay. You never know what could happen, plus it at least gives the impression that you care.
I do care. In fact, I care too much, which is why I can't take just sitting around doing nothing while everyone else gets opportunities.
We're still relatively new here. I think you just need to give it more time.
We've been in NXT for months and I've barely been on TV. And other than you, no one even knows who I am. It's like high school all over again, right down to having to ask permission to use the bathroom.
Who makes you do that?
Cassius Ohno. Wait, is he just messing with me? See? Exactly like high school.
Look, bathroom pranks aside, I think you're overreacting.
Really? Watch this. Hey, Ricochet! Good luck with your match tonight.
Oh, thanks, Troy.
He almost got your name right. That's a start.
If that doesn't prove my point, I've also asked just about everyone on the roster to be my partner for the Dusty Classic, and they all said no. Or worse, ignored me.
Okay, fine. Maybe there's some truth to what you're saying, but I still believe it'll get better.
Do you think anyone would catch on if you disguised yourself as a man so you could be my partner?
As much as I'd love to try to pull that off, I'm focused on beating Rhea Ripley to get a shot at the NXT Women's Championship. It's gonna be tough since she still hasn't gotten over the fact that I beat her in the Mae Young Classic.
But at least you have the Mae Young Classic win. It proved you belong here. My problem is everyone thinks I'm just riding your coattails. Well, you know what? From now on, I'm gonna ride my own coattail.
How do you plan on doing that?
I need to do something big to get people's attention. Something that'll change the narrative. And I need to do it tonight.
I like the fact that you're not just giving up and going home. But keep in mind, I put my reputation on the line by getting you hired here. So anything you do ultimately reflects back on me.
I understand. But you have nothing to worry about. Hey, do you know where I could get some handcuffs on short notice?
And now I'm worried.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall and will determine the number one contender for the NXT Women's Championship!
Wait a second, what's he doing out here?
Before we get to that match, which my friend Red is gonna dominate, there's something I need to say. When I was signed to NXT, I was told to make the most of my opportunity. Well, so far, the only opportunity I've had is to sit in the back every week like some kind of glorified cheerleader, watching everyone else do their thing, while I ask myself over and over again why I'm not out here. Maybe it's because I'm not good enough in the ring. Or I don't have the right look, or I rub someone the wrong way. Or maybe it's simply because my friend helped me get a job and no one can see me as anything other than a charity case. I could drive myself crazy trying to figure it out, but one thing's for sure. If I never get a chance to show what I'm capable of, how will anyone know if I deserve to be here or not? Luckily, there's a tournament coming up that has put countless NXT superstars on the map. The Dusty Classic. Only problem is, I've tried and tried to find a partner, and so far, all I've gotten is a bunch of no's, blank stares, and who the heck are yous. But there's one person I haven't asked yet. Someone who calls themselves The Dream. But they've never competed in the tournament named after the real Dream, the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. So I'm not leaving this ring until Velveteen Dream comes out and agrees to be my partner.
Wait, are those handcuffs? Are you kidding me? Get this idiot out of the ring. No wonder no one wants to be his partner.
This is certainly an unconventional way of doing things.
Velveteen Dream.
He called out Velveteen Dream, and thankfully, here he comes.
Yeah, hopefully to put an end to this mess.
Velveteen Dream.
So, are you gonna be my partner? Because as you can see, I'm not going anywhere until I get a yes.
The Dream always keeps a spare handcuff key on his person. You never know when you might need it. If you want the Dream to be your partner, then you need to prove yourself by beating the Dream in a match later tonight. You got the Dream's attention, but let's see if you can keep it.
That was certainly unexpected, but Velveteen Dream has made a career out of defying expectations.
Look, I don't care how weird that was. At least Velveteen got the ball out of the ring.
Let's get back to the previously scheduled match.
Was all that?
Me riding my own coattail.
Well, maybe give me a heads up next time you're gonna hijack the show right before my match.
You got this.
We apologize again for the delay in bringing you this number one contender match for Candice LeRae's NXT Women's Championship.
Delay is a much nicer term than I would have used.
You have to wonder if that interruption will throw either of these women off their game tonight.
That's a valid question. But knowing the history they have with each other going back to last year's Mae Young Classic, I think both Red and Rhea will be more focused on the task at hand. She's bringing the pressure on now,
showing a lot of fury with her attacks.
Defenseless in the corner now.
Drop kick with precision.
A striking blow. Oh, right to her gut.
That's what you call a bad landing.
She's forced onto the defensive now.
She still has a lot of time to recover, though.
Oh, what impact.
If you look up bad attitude in the dictionary, I'm pretty sure you'll see Rhea Ripley's photo right there on the page. Rhea Ripley is the walking, talking personification of a bad attitude.
You can't look up bad attitude in the dictionary, Saxton. You can look up bad or attitude. I'll give you, Rhea Ripley certainly has attitude.
Oh, absolutely punishing.
Now, trampling the opposition. Knee drop. Hoping to end it early. You're not going to win any matches that easily.
Too soon.
Byron, you talk about Rhea Ripley's bad attitude, but in her mind, she's as happy as can be. There may be a scowl on her face when she's in that ring, but it's only a matter of time before that scowl becomes a smirk as she inflicts damage upon her opponents.
There's the arm wringer, followed by the leg drop.
She's starting to tire a little. She needs to turn the tide here.
Head scissor applied.
God, malicious.
Proving tough.
Uh-oh, the end is near. Here it comes. Rhea's got it hooked. Rhea answers with a decisive big kick.
All right, looks like that rocked Red.
Red counters with a super kick.
Both women are down.
It's over. Hold on. Both women's shoulders were on the mat when the ref counted three.
I saw it too. Can we get some kind of official ruling on this?
Rhea Ripley and Red both believe they won and deserve the title opportunity, so I guess we'll have to wait and see what happens next.
What else could go wrong tonight?
Trey setting up for a suplex, but Velveteen blocks it twice.
Velveteen Dream hits the neck breaker.
Maybe you'll find a partner next year, pal.
And now he's going to the top. This might put an end to Trey's hopes of competing in the Dusty Classic.
Do it, Dream.
Purple Rainmaker. Thankfully, this is all over.
Come on, cover him. What's the holdup?
Wait, what's Velveteen doing?
No.
He's telling the referee to count?
Velveteen Dream is letting Trey win.
You gotta be kidding me.
Yeah.
Come on.